Keith.
Mrs. Boynton.
Here.
Mr. Akins.
Here.
Mrs. Turner Burch.
Present.
Mr. Lifford.
Here.
Mrs. Macklin.
Here.
We all stand for the pledge of allegiance.
Pledge of allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic of which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
If you reference the agenda, we are item number 2 point, before we do that, could you please move?
Visitors are always welcome at our board meetings. If you wish to address the board, please complete the form provided upon arrival at the meeting and give it to our treasurer. Oral presentations are limited to 3 minutes each, so the meeting may proceed uninterrupted. Please silence all electronic devices. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Akins. Now we are at item number 2.01, acknowledgement of our goals. Please read them as you read them. Item number 3.01. Item number 3.01. I'm sorry, we are having some really serious problems with our board doc, and everything just displayed on my screen, so it may happen, and yours just happened to. It's really crazy, so we do apologize for that, so you may see a few pauses during our meeting. 3.01, student handbook presentation. Mr. Ball.
Thank you, Madam President. Dr. Johnson, board members, just a couple of additions to our actually our middle school and high school handbook. One, number 7, for collusion, students should not work together to see people work to cheat, cause harm, deceive staff or other students to the source class. We added that. Another part, number 9, in devices prohibited, we did add devices that are sexual nature and other. Regard to Title IX. Also added another letter under building safety and security. We had students are not permitted to leave the school building or campus without permission. And then we adjusted the letters for F, G, and H. We added number 22, loitering and being out of the area, just to control the have more structure in our building. You can read there, number 22. And then we added under dangerous weapons, we added E, which would be a violation of this provision calls for immediate out of school suspension may result in a possible recommendation for expulsion. And that's under our dangerous instrument, dangerous weapons. And we just added, we just adjusted the letters for lack of.
Tonight there's no vote. We just want to make sure that you get it in your hands, the changes. And then on the 15th, we'll ask for you to vote.
Are we allowed any questions or anything? So can you speak to the context of the collusion addition? Because it's kind of vague.
Yes, so we have some very bright, extremely intelligent young people in this technology world, and so they have been collaborating together to, as I said, work in secret in order to advance academically, which is not prohibited. So students are coming together via different forms of technology to cheat and test. So we added collusion.
So this only for like cheating and theft, because I see the deceiving staff or students, but also adding the disruption of class and school. I'm just asking for more context in vagueness today. And I only speak to, in context of my filter of experience and understanding, children have organizations. So is this just speaking to collaborating in on cell phones? Like, are we gonna be specific? Because if there's organizations and they choose, say for instance, stage a walkout or a sit-in or anything of protest, Would that fall under that?
Well, the advice of the, because we have to send this to our attorney to review, just to make sure that there's no violations
mm-hmm.
of First Amendment rights, and that will fall under policy, your board policy. But this is specifically in relation to maybe some disruptions that occurred. Say there's a collaboration on social media or or something of that nature that causes a fight in school. That's considered a disruption. Well, we have to do a lockdown or something of that nature. But as the law always supersedes.
But can it be more specific to that? I'm just inquiring.
We can ask.
So it has more context. So
yeah. We can ask the board attorney.
Okay.
Like, if that's okay, I think she just sometimes doesn't want to get in a situation where she says, well, it doesn't say that specifically.
Mm-hmm.
But maybe put in an alignment to board policy, blah, 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 blah. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Maybe some kind of reference or something. Just so that wouldn't come back and say, well,
mm-hmm.
in that amendment of student rights.
So it would be okay if it says in alignment to enlist.
And then list the policy that is
okay.
The practice or policy for. Yeah.
Can you make note of that?
Yes.
And you guys, we have like 2 weeks if you guys think of anything else as well.
Under the devices, how is that going to be more controlled or controllable? Because I'm seeing, you know, the cell phones and other electronic devices. However, they also use computers and cell phones, even though they shouldn't be visible, but they do use them, and it says except for approved educational purposes. And I do see where it says see cell phones, but how is that going to be monitored? So under the devices prohibited, and you added the devices that are sexual in nature and or other items, and cell phones is listed under there, and that cell phones and other electronic devices should not be visible, heard, or used at any time on school property during the school day, except for approved educational purposes. However, we know students have phones, and I see that you have seen cell phones, but is this referring to the handbook policy on cell phones, or is it referring to the school policy on cell phones? Because students always have their phones. So how is this even having some control?
This is the student handbook, so we refer to as student handbook.
Okay. And we do have a district policy on cell phones and other use. Could that be also added, maybe? So then you can also not just see the cell phone policy on the district for the school handbook.
In there.
I think she's just asking to say,
okay,
please see policy number.
Okay, yeah.
Kind of like you did with the other one.
Yes.
Because there is a policy on electronic devices.
Once again, just for context and clarity.
All right, thank you.
Any more questions?
Next on the agenda is item number 4.01, where the audience may address the board. Do we have any cards tonight? Did you have?
Oh.
Thank you.
possible extracurricular for our students. And she also has some pictures that she shared with us.
Good evening, everybody.
Good evening.
My name is Valerie Harrison, and the question on my card is, when we are revamping for 24-25, I believe it is, with the new consortium, did I say that correctly? And where they're coming back with the beauticians, nurses assistants, auto mechanics, and masons. The other thing that would also, I would think, be important to include would be agriculture. That is very, very big. A lot of the universities have agriculture in their curriculum or in their colleges, and it's not just farm, but they also have hydroponics, they have it where aquaponics, they have it where dealing with the condition of the soil. It's basically like biology. And there's one particular place that comes out in mind, Riddall. I don't know if you're familiar with that. But Riddall have the children come in and they talk about the condition of the soil. They talk about growing your own, eating your own. And years before the seed came about, COVID, it was scheduled to have like an acre of land to have that scheduled. And I've gone to a couple of schools that viewed that, the agriculture that they put in their curriculum, and it's beneficial because it helps with their budget. And whatever that school grows, it goes back into the school. So any type of vegetables, you know, tomatoes, cucumbers, lettuce, that is something that they grow on their property. And that, the pictures that you're looking at, I took a picture of that because, I apologize, I don't have the name of the school, but I can definitely say Gilmore Academy, they do it. There's a school in the Akron, they also do it. And they grow their food, everything is grown, and that way they do not have to outsource like places that where the food is, you know, we have a shelf life. The shelf life meaning they put pesticide on that food to keep it shelf life to a certain degree, which we know if we add pesticide on our food and we intake it, it's in our bodies. It's something that the children will be able to learn from. That's a big deal. Ohio State does it. I know Tri-C does it. There's another school I can't think of right now. Central State does it. There's a couple other schools that do it. So that's number one. Number two, and I know you'll have to get back to me on that, in regards to when we have children that, and I'm saying this, my title is We Can Do Better. We're always talking about building new buildings. That's great. But inside that building, the old saying, you can take a person out of the country, but you can't take the country out of that person. If they're going into a new building and they still have the same attitude, my time is up.
Yes, you've reached your 3 minutes.
Oh. Okay.
You can close with your question. What was your question?
Say it again.
You can close with your question. You had a question.
To do better with the staff, can the staff be, I know we have these PD, these professional days and everything. But my thing is, can we get individuals in there that can relate to that child, that cannot give them those tags where they've done something, where we're sitting during lunchtime and we're chit-chatting and you get a tag for talking. That's free time. Come on now. I'm just asking to get with, my time is up and I'm going to step away. But to get with the staff and let them know this is not a prison. It's a place where the kids want to learn, develop, grow, and socially. Socially is so, so important amongst our young people. So that was my question. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Harrison.
Good Ms. Harrison, I asked if it was okay if I give you a compliment. I was doing one of my walkthrough. I apologize, I've not been able to do many of those lately, but when I was doing my walkthrough, and you talk a lot about the environment. I know they know you as the beekeeper, and you were doing a presentation.
Yes.
And the kids were so attentive, And you did such a great job. I know, I just want to thank you for giving back to our students and bringing that knowledge to them and how everything we do when we see impacts our environment. So I just want to thank you.
My pleasure. Thank you.
And Dr. Johnson, could you follow up with Ms. Harrison? Because she did have a lot of time to talk about.
Yes, Ms. Therita is here.
To address the question.
And can talk to you about those two key pieces. Thank you. Also, under the previous item, we had approved some new employees, and this is typically that time when we provide you with an opportunity. If you are here and you are new to Bedford City Schools, that you may be if possible stand, tell us who you are and the positions that you would be in the coming school year.
Hi everyone, my name is Gabrielle Taylor. I'm a recent grad from the University of Akron, and I will be taking over a position at Heskett Middle School for intervention specialist. So I'm really excited to join Bedford. Thank you guys for having me.
Thank you.
And hi, my name is Caitlin Nordstrom. I'm a recent grad from Kent State.
Ooh,
and I will be teaching and I will be teaching music at Glendale Primary School. Yeah. Thank you for having me. Welcome.
My name is Chris Petiti. I'm not a recent grad, so I'm a high school guidance counselor. So I'm excited to be here. So I can't wait to get started.
Welcome.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, and welcome to all of you. Glad to join our Bearcat family.
Yes, also going to say welcome to the Bearcat family. Thank you for making the decision to help our students, and we welcome your what you bring to the team.
Congrats to all of you guys. Congratulations.
I'd like to say thank you for choosing to help educate our Bedford students, and welcome to Bedford, and now you will be officially a Bearcat.
Welcome, thank you for coming. I'm a born and bred Bearcat, also a Flash. So thank you for joining the team.
Dr. Johnson.
Thank you. Is it okay if I take 6.05 first? Mr. B has to go take care of something. Is that okay? If I can, well,
sure.
Is that okay? So I have under 6.05, we ask of your request to approve the following items under the Executive Director of Operations.
Board, should I have a motion to approve 6.05, building facilities utilization, that's being presented by the Executive Director of Operations. Can I have a motion, please?
Motion to approve the item from 6.05 as presented.
Mr. Akins?
Yes.
Mrs. Macklin?
Yes.
Mrs. Boynton?
Yes.
Mrs. Turner Birch?
Abstain.
Mr. Lipford?
Yes.
Motion passes 4-1.
Thank you so much. Under 6.051, we have an updated graduation list. Just a reminder, we do have graduation next week, June 6th, rain dates 6th, 7th, and 8th. Under 6.02, we ask of your approval of the following items as brought forth by the Executive of Academic Achievement. We did remove this item last time. There were some questions. I didn't know if you wanted Mr. Harrington to speak to that right now.
Yes, please. We did pull it off last week. If you don't mind, if you could speak to that.
With regards to the A-plus learning contract for the non-public school, because our district receives federal funds, those students who live in Bedford that attend non-public buildings, those buildings are also allowed allocations from the Ohio Department of Education. Through that, any allowable items that they request, as the fiscal agent, we have to have a consultation with them and then identify if it is allowable, and then they're able to use those funds in whatever way they want to. Sometimes they will use them to contract with a company for tutoring. Sometimes they'll do contracts for a counselor. It just depends on what they want to use the funds for. We don't have the liberty to deny them the usage of funds. If we don't have ongoing consultations with the non-publics, we are liable to lose our federal funds. So that's why the contract is on there. It's something that the non-public wanted to enter into with this company. Also, to not forget, they were identified to have a few extra funds towards the end of the year, and they just wanted to extend the contract with this company. So
what was the original contract time?
It was through the end of the year. I can't remember off the top of my head. I apologize. I don't have it in front of me either. But it was just through this school year,
right,
if I'm not mistaken.
And this is through the end of June 30th.
June 30th, 2023?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's the fiscal year.
Correct. So I guess this is where the confusion was last time, is because it says it's an extension, it's through the school year originally, but this is saying that it's still through the end of the school year.
I think because it was an amendment because of the amount of money they had. So they didn't extend the length of time of the contract. They just wanted to do an addendum to the amount of money that they had allowable to them from earlier in the year. So it doesn't go beyond the current fiscal school year.
But it don't say anything about money in here as far as dollar amount or anything.
Because it wasn't necessary to put the dollar amount in there. It was just saying, hey, you're just making an amendment to this contract. We're going to continue using our funds for that. I know it may sound confusing, but
yeah.
It went to legal and it was approved. Yeah.
Because I think the bottom line, like, we don't have,
like,
it's kind of a formality because
yeah.
We are just the fiscal agent where, like, the money just kind of flows through us,
mm-hmm.
per se.
So it's just basically.
Yeah, we can't.
What they need to do on their end,
yes.
Just to say they had that done so that they can get their
consultation
money.
Happened. We verify that they're still using a company that's allowable for whatever usage. So that's why I was there.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
And I would like to make a correction. 6.03 is what Mr. Harrington was speaking on. 6.02.
Yeah, excuse me. I was talking because I was like confused. I thought I was looking at summer study.
And that's on me.
I
don't
know
what
I
said.
I
said 6.02 and I'm looking at 6.03.
I'm just going to stay just in case.
Questions about summer study? So, yeah, 6.02 is a summer study. So, I was looking at 6.03. So 6.02 is a summer study. 6.03 is the item that there were questions about. 6.04, ask of your approval of the following administrative personnel. You already went over 6.05. Under 6.06, we ask of your approval of the following item in regards to the master facilities plan, as well as 6.07. And under 6.08, we ask of your approval of the following revised policies.
All right, we will start with 6.01. and we will take these individually because we do need to do 6.06 and 7 in that order. So 6.01, could I have a motion to approve the graduate list as it is presented? And it's Exhibit S-1, 2023 graduates. Could I have a motion, please?
Excuse me.
Motion to approve a list of graduates.
Second. It's been moved by Ms. Turner-Burt and second by Mrs. Macklin. Board, do we have any discussion on the graduate list or any questions? Hearing none, roll call, please.
Mrs. Turner-Burt?
Yes.
Mrs. Macklin?
Yes.
Mrs. Boynton?
Yes.
Mr. Akins?
Abstain.
Mr. Lifford?
Yes.
Motion passes 4-1. Thank you, Board. And 6.02, we have to have a motion to approve the summer studies as they are presented.
I make a motion to approve the summer studies as they are presented.
Second.
It's been moved by Mrs. Macklin, second by Mr. Akins. Do we have any questions or discussion, Board, in regards to the summer studies? And we could see those. Exhibit AA2, AA-4, AA-5. Any questions? Hearing none, roll call, please.
Mrs. Macklin?
Yes.
Mr. Akins?
Yes.
Mrs. Boynton?
Yes.
Mrs. Turner-Burch?
Yes.
And Mr. Lifford?
Yes.
Motion passes 5-0. Thank you. And 6.03, could I have a motion to approve the service contract as it is presented in Exhibit AA-1.
Motion to approve.
Second.
It has been moved by Mrs. Turner-Burch and second by Mrs. Macklin. Any questions for? Hearing none, roll call, please.
Mrs. Turner-Burch?
Yes.
Mrs. Macklin?
Yes.
Mrs. Boynton?
Yes.
Mr. Akins?
Yes.
Mr. Lifford?
Yes.
Motion passes 5-0. Thank you, Board. 6.04, I need a motion to approve the administrative personnel moves. There's some contracts here, some recommendations, rather, and some amendments to a contract. So could I have a motion to approve the administrative personnel contract renewals?
I'll make a motion to approve administrative personnel contract renewals.
Could I have a second, please?
Second.
It's been moved by Mr. Akins and second by Mrs. Macklin. Any discussion, Board? Hearing none, roll call, please.
Mr. Akins?
Yes.
Mrs. Macklin?
Yes.
Mrs. Boynton?
Yes.
Mrs. Turner-Burch?
Yes.
And Mr. Lifford?
Yes.
Motion passes 5-0. Thank you, Board. And 6.06. Could I have a motion to approve the resolution for the master facilities plan as presented?
Motion to approve resolution for the master facilities plan as presented.
Second, please.
Second.
It's been moved by Mr. Akins and second by Mrs. Macklin. Any discussion? Any questions for Abby? She is here tonight. Do you have any questions? Hearing none, roll call, please.
Mr. Akins?
Yes.
Mrs. Macklin?
Yes.
Mrs. Boynton?
Yes. Yes.
Mrs. Turner-Burch?
Yes.
And Mr. Lifford?
Yes.
Motion passes 5-0. Thank you, Board. And 6.07 is the resolution in regards to what we just approved, which is the resolution for the master facility plan. Could I have a motion, please?
I make a motion to approve the resolution for the master facility plan.
Second.
It has been moved by Mrs. Macklin and second by Mr. Akins again. have any questions, Abby is here to answer for us. Hearing none, roll call, please.
Mrs. Macklin?
Yes.
Mr. Akins?
Yes.
Mrs. Boynton?
Yes.
Mrs. Turner Burch?
Yes.
And Mr. Lippert?
Yes.
Motion passes 5-0. Thank you, board. 6.08. And these are our board policies. We've had an opportunity to look at these policies. So if I could have a motion to approve the revised board policies as they are presented. They're in Exhibit F-1.
Motion to approve the following revised board policies as presented.
Second.
It has been moved by Mr. Akins and second by Mrs. Macklin. Any questions about any of the policies, board? Any discussion? Hearing none, roll call, please.
Mr. Akins?
Yes.
Mrs. Macklin?
Yes.
Mrs. Boynton?
Yes.
Mrs. Turner Burch?
Yes.
Mr. Lippert?
Yes.
Motion passes 5-0. Thank you, board.
Can I just say one thank you for your support of the exhibits? I know there were a lot of them, but also thank you to the board and all the committee members of the facilities committee. I know there's a lot more work to do. For Tabby and I and everybody else, the real work begins now, but I just want to thank the board and the entire facilities committee.
Thank you, Dr. Johnson. Item number 7 is our treasury report, 7.01.
All right, board president, Mrs. Boynton, vice president, Mr. Akins, and board members, I have 3 items to present to you tonight. We have our after-the-fact purchase orders for approval. We have 4 donations. We have a donation from the Lions Club to help pay off our students' debt. We have 2 donations from the Rotary Club, one being a camera, and the second being water bottles, keychains, and various items for, I think, Hesped Field Day. And then the last item, okay, there's just those three. Oh, because Rotary Club had 2 separate items. Let me correct myself. The 4th one was from Planet Fitness for those items for Field Day. And then also the approval of purpose and goals for our SAD and also approval to conduct fundraising.
All right.
Can I have a motion to approve the treasurer's report as is presented for?
I make a motion to approve the treasurer's report as presented.
Second.
It has been moved by Mrs. Macklin and second by Mr. Akins. Do we have any questions for her?
I got a question. When did we know Planet Fitness is going to make that donation?
Form was filled out May the 3rd.
Okay. Any more questions for her? Hearing none, roll call, please.
Mrs. Macklin?
Yes.
Mr. Akins?
Yes.
Mrs. Boynton?
Yes.
Mrs. Turner Burch?
Yes.
Mr. Lippert?
Yes.
Motion passes 5-0. Next on the item is Board of Education New Business, Old Business, and it's the approval 8.01, approval of the third party investigators' findings. I need a motion to approve the resolution as it is presented. This is the first of the resolution for this anti-harassment investigations. If I can have a motion, please.
Motion motion to approve resolution as presented.
Second.
So moved by Mr. Akins and second by Mrs. Macklin. Board, do you have any questions? I would like to say that this is the initial, this is not the resolution where you will see all the information. This is just giving me, the board president, the approval to look over the findings of the investigation before a final resolution comes to the board. Roll call, please.
Mr. Akins?
Yes.
Mrs. Macklin?
Yes.
Mrs. Boynton?
Yes.
Mrs. Turner Birch?
No.
And Mr. Lifford?
Yes.
Motion passes 4-1. Thank you, board. We are down to item number 9, which is the adjournment. I would just like to ask the board if they have any announcements or anything to you would like to share at this time before we adjourn the meeting.
Just want to say that next week we are our seniors will hopefully and hopefully be a crossing stage. I just want to congratulate them again for their efforts this year. They dealt with COVID and having to be remote for a little bit, so I'm thankful that they pushed through and they will represent us well.
I have a couple things. First, happy Pride Month. Also, happy National Black Child Month. It is a great month. The National Black Child Month is also in the month of Juneteenth is celebrated. So, and National Black Child Week is towards the end of the month. So, just want to say let's uplift our children in this space, and in doing so, congratulations to all of our 2023 graduates. Tenacity, endurance, and strength is what you took to get through, whether you have straight A's and a 4.0, or you were just trying to make it and get by through all the struggles that you had to endure. May those struggles keep you safe. May the road lead you to your destiny of every purpose that you are set out to do, and you will be great.
I would like to remind you again of the golfing, July 11th, right? August 11th. Bring your clubs. Got that right.
Not your racket.
Not your racket.
Well, I'm learning how to play pickleball now, so. But I also want to say that I donate, I have my own business, and I try to do things for the school. I'm a Bedford, my blood is green. My family's been in Bedford since 1931, so you know I've been here a long time. But what I try to do is I try to do things for the district to help. Today I went to, for the second year, I went to Heskett for their field day, and I donated my grill, which is fantastic, but I donated my grill. And the kids really, really enjoyed it. And the only thing that I'm really kind of upset about is we have all these schools here, and I told them I would donate my grill, and Heston's the only one who ever stepped up and say, we'll take it. So hopefully, maybe next year, some other schools will let their students see what Heston is seeing. The kids were really, really respectful. They were so grateful. They really enjoyed it. So I just want to give kudos to Heston and let them know that it was worth my while. It was worth me getting up early because I'm not a morning person. But that's all I wanted to say. Thank you, Hester, for having me.
I wasn't going to say anything, but what Mr. Akins said about our kids, just to add to that, just a big salute to all of our educators. All the teachers that, with a genuine heart, are trying to help our kids be successful as people and giving their time and effort every day to deal and to educate through very difficult times. So all of those kids that are graduating owe a great debt of gratitude to the adults that cared about them and helped them every day. And so to all of those that are watching our board of you and are part of our district, thank you to you for your service and your help of our kids, because that means everything. So thank you.
And on top of that, actually, mark my attention. I would like to thank our security personnel as well for keeping our students safe this year. We've seen in the news a lot of different things have been going on with other schools, so I'm just grateful that our staff here has been diligent, dealing with watching what items are brought into the buildings, reporting items that are found, and overall just keeping our children safe this year. One final thing is I would like to just personally thank the Lions Club and Bedford Rotary Club for their donations. It means a lot that you continue to care for our students, and just want you to know that we definitely appreciate that. The students appreciate it as well, and it shows that you care about the future of our district, so thank you.
Since you brought up the Rotary, and it just slipped my mind, was that last week? The CTE, I attended the Rotary CTE recognition program in which they honored seniors who were in trades and the accomplishments that they've done in their respective areas of study. So I just wanted to say kudos to that event as well as to those students that have achieved well and are doing well in their crafts and that they may continue to pursue and do well in those areas as they exit.
And I just have one announcement, our Juneteenth celebration. And if you did not pick up a flyer, please pick up one as you, Battle has one. Oh, sorry, Gina. We will have a community Juneteenth celebration on June 19th at 6 o'clock.
It's from 5 p.m.
I know, I needed the flyer.
Oh, I'm sorry.
5 p.m. You're all welcome to join the Bedford City School District in collaboration with our communities of Bedford, Bedford Heights, Oakwood Village, and Walton Hills as we celebrate freedom at the Bedford High School Bearcat Stadium on June 19, 2023, 5 to 7 p.m. We have all kinds of things lined up so we can celebrate this great day, and we hope that you can come out. And if you want to be a part of this celebration, not just by your presence, but if you just want to do something, please see me and you can be on this piece of life. We will acknowledge you, so whatever you can do to help us with that celebration, we really do appreciate it. Thank you.
One more thing, I would like to thank Denise for all that she's done. She's just been so wonderful, and I don't even know how to put her in words. But I think you've been doing a wonderful job, and we really appreciate everything you do for us. Thank you.
Thank you.
Macklin?
Yes.
Mrs. Turner Birch?
Yes.
Mrs. Boynton?
Yes.
Mr. Akins?
Yes.
Mr. Lippert?
Yes.
Motion passes 5-0.